the middle of the James River between Surry County and Newport News, Virginia, the Sturgis, a former World War II Liberty ship, converted to a power barge in the 1960s, sits dormant. Its nuclear reactor hasn't produced an electron since the mid-1970s. The ship is scheduled to be decommissioned and dismantled in Texas later this year. In its heyday, the vessel provided power to the Panama Canal Zone.
We were putting 10 megawatt of electricity out to the Panama Canal grid every hour.
This, by today's standards, is not a lot.
This is a 10 megawatt plant. The average nuclear power plant in the United States or anywhere else in the world is in the order of 1 to 1.5 or 2 gigawatts, which is several times larger than a 10 megawatt plant.
But it was the right fit for Panama's tiny power grid.
You could see the various resistance loads increase in the morning when people got up and turned their heaters on and toasters on, this kind of stuff. So it was a grid small enough that you could actually see the impact of what this ship was doing.
For nearly 40 years, the ship has sat quiet. Its fuel rods taken off board many years ago, its transmission towers long removed, and its men no longer manning the dials and watching the meters. With ever-increasing costs for maintenance and no future projected use for the vessel, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is implementing a plan to decommission it. In 2014, the Corps of Engineers received a permit from the Army's Reactor Office for the decommissioning of the MH-1A, the empty nuclear reactor on board the Sturgis. Hans Hunterlaw, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Baltimore District Program Manager and health physicist, says the radioactive material slated for removal poses a low risk of exposure.
There's probably more dangerous stuff underneath everyone's kitchen sink that if you mix two things together that's readily available, you have a higher potential to harm yourself than you do working in and or around the Sturgis and its decommissioning.
Hunterlaw says the primary residual radioactive material remaining on the Sturgis is in the form of large pieces of metal that became radioactive during the operation of the reactor. These radioactive pieces of metal don't really have the ability to transfer the radioactivity through contact with other media, such as water, soil, or people.
That's the primary residual radioactive material left. So if water got in, water got out, the metal is still a solid piece, chunk of metal. And I don't see any potential there for a release to the environment.
Once the residual radioactive materials associated with the former nuclear reactor are removed, Hunterlaw says the intent is to send the remainder of the vessel for scrap metal. The vessel is being towed from its moorings in the James River Reserve Fleet to Galveston, Texas, where the work of removing the residual radioactive material will take place. Robert Schultz, a retired Army Lieutenant Colonel, was responsible for taking possession of the ship for the Army from the Martin Marietta Corporation, the company in charge of retrofitting the Liberty ship into the nuclear power barge. For Schultz, coming back aboard the ship 43 years after he left it to deploy to Vietnam reminded him of the crew he was in charge of during the nuclear power barge's operation.
I spent 26 years in the military, and this was the greatest crew there was.
The work in Galveston is expected to last 14 to 18 months. From Newport News, Virginia, Patrick Bloodgood.